Well, imagine you're hurt in a car accident and your lawyer gets you a big settlement. It sounds good. But what if your lawyer settled your case in secret and then kept your share of the money?
Well, that's what a group of angry clients of a prominent Cobb County attorney believe happened to them. And senior Fox 5 I-Team reporter Dale Russell says those clients finally convinced the police that the lawyer should be investigated.
The trailer came flying across the highway and nailed me head on.
I was hit by a truck and my car was totaled. I hit the back of the seat so hard it split the leather.
These three women share a common bond.
53 square, 1028.
All three hurt in a car accident. All three hired a lawyer named Richard Merritt to sue for damages and medical care. All three won settlements. But according to this Cobb County police warrant, their lawyer never told them he settled their cases. He was charged with stealing their money. All of it. Beverly Braswell, $50,000 settlement.
I felt betrayed. I felt violated. The lies, the deceit. I trusted this person.
Tina Saylor, $75,000 settlement.
I felt stupid. It was like, how could I let this guy get over on me like this? How could I have not seen this coming?
Myrna Evans, $9,000 settlement.
I was in shock. I couldn't even believe it.
At the time, these women didn't know about each other. But the strangers connected after Tina Saylor began writing negative reviews about Merritt on social media sites like this Yelp page.
So the three women found out they were not alone. And then we're stunned to find out that 2 years earlier, two sisters tried to get the Cobb Sheriff's Department to arrest Richard Merritt for stealing their settlement checks.
Seven counts of theft by taking.
Cobb County Police arrested Merritt in January of this year on multiple counts of theft and exploiting the elderly. Two of his former clients identified in the warrant were in court during a recent bond hearing. Claire and Ingrid Hansen tried to have Merritt arrested by the Cobb Sheriff's Department in 2015. They filed a complaint, signed an affidavit. They gave investigators a letter spelling out how Merritt illicitly settled our case for $70,000 and kept the money. The sisters told me the Sheriff's Department investigator said he could not make a criminal case.
Cobb County Sheriff's Office were notified about the first victim in 2015. If they would have acted at that time, none of us would be injured.
A Sheriff's Department spokesman told me their investigator thought the sisters were involved in a civil dispute, not criminal, and that it would ultimately be resolved in court, even though there was no civil court case at the time.
So Merritt continued to practice law, living what appeared to be a rich life, complete with his Porsche, trips posted on his Facebook page that included deep sea fishing, Braves baseball, and beach resort getaways. Beverly Braswell saw it all. She lived in his neighborhood.
He looked like he was living large.
Living large, most definitely.
He didn't just look it, he was living it.
He was, yes. And bragged about it.
Yes, flaunted it.
Yes.
Then in February of last year, the Hansen sisters tried again. They went to magistrate court and asked a judge to take out a citizen's warrant against the well-known and well-heeled Cobb attorney. The judge said yes. That warrant sparked a massive Cobb County Sheriff's Department investigation that led to Merritt's arrest in January.
Bad check over $1,500.
At a recent bond hearing, Merritt came face to face with a courtroom packed with his alleged victims. 16 victims in all, according to the warrant. And prosecutor Jason Marbitt told the judge those victims' losses were staggering.
The court is looking at somewhere in the order of between $400,000 and $500,000 of money that was stolen from the victims that are alleged in this warrant.
Several victims, we were not allowed to show their faces during testimony, told the judge about the pain of their loss, including his wife, who has now filed for divorce.
I'm in financial ruin. He squandered every cent we had with his income as a lawyer and mine as a doctor.
In the end, Judge Joyette Holmes granted a $400,000 bond as the massive theft case against Richard Merritt finally moves forward. Merritt voluntarily surrendered his law license, admitting he settled a $75,000 case but didn't give the money to his client, and his alleged victims struggle to piece their lives back together.
He's done so much damage, not only financially, to all of us.
Our lives have been turned upside down.
Upside down.
Here's just one example of the problems they face. Beverly Braswell says doctors and hospitals are pressing her for payment for treating her injuries from that wreck, but the money from the settlement is gone. So far, all three women have been told by lawyers they can't get their settlements overturned. Dale Russell, Fox 5 News.